Hi, my name is Livia Tenuta and I'm assistant professor at the design department of Politecnico di Milano. My research is dedicated to future scenarios and innovation for fashion, focusing in particular on wearable accessories. Today we will explore the fashion tech paradigm, focusing on the following topic: the analysis of the intersection between fashion and technology, going through history but also contemporary case studies. Then we will see a zoom on the state of the art of fashion tech, intended as actors involved in all the supply chain, including a definition of the three main areas of interest: smart textiles, wearable technologies, and digital manufacturing. Then we will see the future scenarios for fashion tech. About the intersection of the fashion field with the one of technology, over the years, fashion and innovation have often come to collide, growing closer and contaminating one another in attempts at testing each other's limits, guaranteeing better performing products or systems, essentially to improve one another. In history, technological innovation reached peaks of progress identified as industrial revolutions and always presented some connection with the fashion world. The first industrial revolution between the end of the 18th century and the beginning of the 19th century deeply changed the textile sector, not just for the invention of the Jacquard loom that significantly sped up production times, but also for the birth of a new industrial model aimed at homologation and ready-made garments. Production became quicker and, by consequence, changes to experience acceleration. With electric power station and light bulbs, the product of the second revolution, the activity of the industrial machines had increasingly growing rhythms, and once again fashion was directly involved. The new chemical techniques and the invention of steel introduced less costly materials. The third industrial revolution that began around the 50s brought further developments in electronics, telematics, and information technology. It is hard to establish its exact beginning, but it is widely agreed that the year 1947 can be taken as the marker for the moment in which technological development underwent significant acceleration. This is when the first transistor was born, the father of all the technological devices that would later reach the mass market. Immediately after, in the 50s, the radio, the television and the cinema all had their boom and also became the means through which fashion indirectly communicated. Communication had become immediate, transportation increasingly fast, and a new frontier was opening up to man, the universe. The 60s and the space age, with the race to space that followed the launch of Soviet satellite Sputnik 1, are the years when the information reached people simultaneously and continuously. This ferment is absorbed by fashion in the form of formal and material inspiration. Let's think in 1964, André Courrèges launched his Moon Girl collection, followed by Couture Future, Hyperbole and Prototype. This sci-fi trend will make a comeback in the 80s, accompanied by the explosion of artificial materials. Through these were patented some years earlier the first wearable technologies, the Walkman, and transportable such as mobile phones and portable computers, in parallel to the boom of the internet. With the birth of the computer, industrial machines make way for intangible goods, with the shift from hardware to software. By this point, the IT revolution was no longer the domain of only the research subculture. The 90s are the years of the internet, and the web is increasingly seen by advertisers as a tool to help with publication and spread of contents. This invention has an impact similar to that of the printing press, thanks to its democratization. Widespread access to technology leads to a significant reduction in terms of costs and to the shift to the new economy that produces a demand for technological innovation and optimism about technology-driven progress. These are the years in which Andrew Finberg, a key thinker in the philosophy of technology, publishes Questioning Technology, in which he claims that democratization of technology has the effect of attributing new meanings to technological design. As inclusivity grows, the user becomes the designer and directly intervenes in this process, anticipating the contemporary do-it-yourself trend. Another great revolution comes in the first decade of our century. The birth of social networks, along with that which Henry Jenkins has defined participatory culture, which becomes a communication tool for fashion, alongside fashion blogging and the spread of platform for the sale of products online, such as YOOX, that was born precisely in 2000s. But what about today? From design to retail, from product to communication, fashion and technology are interconnected, and the shift from craft to industrial production, from analog to digital, involves all the stages of the production process, improving them and making them quicker and more efficient. We can visualize three different scenarios in which fashion and technology merge. The first one is hypercraft, 3D to design and production. The second one is embedded technologies, apparel and accessories. And the third one is about augmented and virtual reality and retail. Starting from the very first one, the one of hypercraft, in the fashion field, increasingly specific software has been developed for clothing, such as Broadswear and Optitex, transformed 2D patterns into realistic 3D patterns, creating virtual prototypes to test wearability, color variants, and materials, but also for accessories such as Rhino Gold for jewelry, and 3D design, for example, for have a vast library of specific materials. Once the 3D shape is created, not only can its aesthetic impact and proportion, as well as different color variants, be tested, but the garment or the accessory can really be tested, even though they are intangible products. This is made possible by the concept of virtual prototyping that allows the user to directly interact with the digital product as if it were real. The shape, look, manufacturing, and physical behavior can be defined, and the specifics of an accessory or garment subsequently obtained. And the designer is able to interact with it, test its usability, visualize and test it in different stages and for different users. The look, not only defined in detail, can be immediately tested by the designer for its impact and emotional component on the user, and as the design becomes more complex and engineered, its structure, material, geometry, and specifics for product development can be carefully defined. We are talking about size, placement, cut, assembly. The final product can be shown to buyers and even be personalized before going into production, or it can be displayed in the point of sale for the final user. The impact of this new testing method not only completely changes the traditional product development cycle from design, build, test, fix to design, analyze, test, build, but also improves communication between the parties involved in the product development process, bringing products to the market more quickly, with reduced costs and timescales, thus facilitating innovation. Making all the process faster and smarter is one of the goals of the combination of fashion, technology and design. When it comes to automation in textiles and apparel production, ambition can be seen to shift from process-focused automation to full automation in order to be able to produce with minimal human interaction. The increase in automation in order to respond better to customer demand can be illustrated by, for example, Amazon's patent for on-demand apparel manufacturing system, along with Zara's RFID tags on their garments, which both take advantage of available data and automation possibilities. Furthermore, 3D modeling has gained momentum also in automating the production process, specifically with 3D printing, an additive manufacturing process through which an object is built layer after layer, starting from a 3D model. 20 years from its first patenting, 3D printing made a comeback in 2005 thanks to the RepRap project, but its real boom came in 2012 when several companies became interested. The subsequent increase in supply and the technology's increased accessibility brought about by the reduction in costs. The prices have fallen to such an extent that the 3D printed market today is aimed not only at the industry, but also at the single user. Digital craftsmen who, with the new technologies of desktop manufacturing, can transform themselves from creators to entrepreneurs and directly manage the whole of the production process online with clear benefits in terms of times and costs. In terms of business, many markets gradually came to understand the potential of 3D printing, from architecture to bioengineering, from product design to medicine. In the medical world, in particular, the advantages in the production and personalization of external and internal prostheses was quickly intuited. Fashion too understood and exploited the advantages of 3D printing very early. We are on the brink of the third industrial revolution, claims Joris Debbo, creative director of MGX by Materialize, referring to the new technologies and the new materials and adding that nothing will be able to stop the entry of 3D outfits in our wardrobes. It is not by chance that MGX by Materialize engaged in the building of the first 3D printed garment by Iris van Herpen in collaboration with Daniel Widrick already as far back as 2009. The young Dutch designer was the first to show an interest in the innovative printing technology and to apply a method that is entirely representative of the changes of the fashion system that are right now ongoing. Not only fashion, but also the world of underwear and accessories has tried their hand at 3D printing production. Victoria's Secret lingerie in collaboration with Swarovski, for example, or New Balance launched the Zante Generate, the first 3D printed shoes. Or experimentation has also involved the hats, sufficient to look at the marvelous products by Gabriella Ligenza, or bags such as the Armor Clutch, one of the projects by Maison 203 in collaboration with Odo Fioravanti. or creating a system and not a single product through generative design methods and complex forms. In this nervous system offers users various personalization possibilities thanks to their direct interaction with the system to determine the final result. Starting precisely with the user's entry into the production process, new virtual platforms are appearing. We can think to iMaterialize, Shapeways, Sculpteo, or Tingiverse that are the main in that sector, on which it suffices to upload a design for it to be produced and sold online. This process is very different from the traditional one and significantly shortens the production chain, as well as giving users the possibility to customize their products by choosing the materials of which they should be made. The trend to personalization in fashion is not new and has been around for several years, as users want to wear something that is not only made exactly to their taste, but also for their body. Technology also gives an answer to this need for made-to-measure with 3D scanning, the new frontier of sizing, something like a virtual tailor. Today we can have a piece of clothing or accessory made-to-measure simply thanks to body scanning technology that scans one's body or a specific area that then becomes the basis for the construction of a 3D model that, worn by an avatar, anticipates what the real model will look like. Thanks to virtual prototyping, these models can be consulted, tested, modified, and perfected just as if they were real, yet without the use of productive or material resources. This is about hypercraft, but now we can move to the second category: embedded technologies, apparel, and accessories. If production and design technologies are widely used and spread, the field of integrated technologies in the fashion product is instead much more restricted. According to Sabine Seymour, fashionable wearables in the shape of clothing, accessories, and jewelry are epidermal interfaces that, by incorporating elements from embedded technologies, are interactive. It means that they can use sensors, actuators, microprocessors, etc. The wearables can vary between different levels of expressiveness and functionality, where the focus ranges between style and function, with the purpose of fashionability to health and well-being. So, fashion product refers to two different categories: clothing and accessories. Clothes usually make use of smart materials, whilst accessories integrate technology inside their shell and are defined wearables. Although their approach to technology is very different today. In the past, accessories were a subcategory of clothing and thus followed the same rules. At the end of the 19th century, the first hints at wearable technology appeared in clothes, necklaces and hats with a dominant theme, light. Electricity is inserted in the outfit, and the aim of the technology was to contribute to decorating the body, lightening it up, and creating unusual performances almost enchanted. This approach is not so different to the contemporary one. Suffice it to think to the work of Moritz Waldemeyer, such as the hat made of 6,000 LED lights for the Philip Tracy show. Going back to the past, only later was it understood that clothes could do many things, take on a life of their own and change the language of fashion. In 1968, the Museum of Contemporary Craft in New York hosted the exhibition Body Covering with the aim of analyzing the relation between technology and clothing. Astronaut suits were on display next to clothes that inflated and deflated, lit up, heated up, and cooled down, and left open many application scenarios made possible by the interaction between fashion and technology. Scenarios which were, however, not immediately understood and explored. The first research to give significant results were those that began in 1985 by Harry Wainwright, who created a sweatshirt on the surface of which a cartoon was played. In the following years, he continued research around fiber optics and LEDs integrated in materials until 2012, when he presented a smartphone-controlled material that could change colors at the Textile and Colorist Conference in Melbourne. The 2000s saw intense experimentations on the integration of clothing and technology with different approaches. Underwear, the male and female underwear, thought by Durex to allow two bodies to communicate from distance with the help of the iPhone that acts as a controller and stimulator for specific sensitive areas of the male and female body. Moreover, clothes were made that respond to outside stimuli, such as the interactive dress by Ying Gao, made with photoluminescent threads and provided of an eye-tracking system that responds to the eye contact by activating small motors that move the parts of the material. Or the collection of dresses by Amy Winters, made in holographic leather that reacts to sound. Alternatively, light is not the output, but rather the input for the garment. Tommy Hilfiger presented solar panel jacket with a pocket that charges mobile devices thanks to the presence of solar panels, as already proposed a year earlier by Pauline Van Dongen in the solar shirt. Further, clothes have been designed that base their concept on the theme of connection and privacy. Cute Circuit made a dress in 2012 for a specific concert with 2000 LED lights to visualize in real time the tweets posted by participants. Or Dan Rosegard made Intimacy a dress that become transparent based on the number of interaction between the users. The Brazilian designer and researcher Ricardo Nascimento made the Paparazzi Lover, a dress with 62 small LED lights embedded across its surface that, when stimulated by a light flash, such as that of a camera, react by lighting up. And yet, although many solutions have been tested due to the limits of technology integrated into clothing, it mainly is utilized in haute couture with the making of highly scenographic dresses suited to a show or performance, but with little use in the real world, as well as being difficult to reproduce in big numbers. Hussein Chalayan is famously one of the main figures of this experimental direction in fashion. One example is his 111 mechanical dress from SS 2007 that recalls Paco Rabanne's haute couture mid-60s robotic style, where pieces of aluminium were held together by rings that allowed for their movement. Chalayan, on the other hand, makes his dress really move by controlling them thanks to the inbuilt circuits. The dress blooms like a flower and it opens up. Even before, in 2000s, the British Turkish designer was fascinated by the controlled movement of a dress that opened up to reveal the presence of tulle underneath. Albeit existing, the number of garments that are useful and practical is very limited. One example is Move by Electric Foxy, a sports vest with four movement sensors that recognize the precise position the shoulders and back should occupy during a given exercise and detect the percentage of risk of injury. Niedlinger designed a light line of sweatshirts with electrodes in contact with the skin that capture and express the effects in the form of colored lights, red to signal nervousness, blue to show calmness. In other cases, the technology has both ornamental value and a functional one, such as in the case of the wild uniforms made by Gloucester and designed by Claire Barrow for the staff of the London Double Woo Club. Jackets and gilets are provided with a fiber optic light system that pulsates to the rhythm of the music played in the club by the DJ. The clothes do not only look good, they are uniforms to distinguish the staff from the crowd of clubbers. These are sporadic cases that mostly remain confined to specific and isolated fields. Thus, although integrating technology with fashion presents opportunities from the point of view of scenography, mainly for haute couture, and it presents two main limitations for ready-to-wear. First, such a significant progress has been made in the properties of the materials. That materials with smart features are preferable to the integration of technology and sensors in the fabrics. Innovation in the fashion world has often focused on the materials, at least since the 80s, with the boom of artificial materials and the incredible progress has been made in the properties of materials, initially in the military or sports world, and later translated into the fashion world. Fabrics that change their features based on the temperature of the body or of the environment, and high-performance materials are no longer just a cover, but rather a dispenser or container of functions. These materials are much easier to manage, both in terms of production and use, than integrated technology that, on the contrary, can represent an important burden for clothing. While it is a success point for wearables, the first sign of a wearable technological accessory can be found during the 16th century, with the invention of the clock worn on the body, followed by the pulsal calculator during the half of the 20th century, and then the Bluetooth headphones in the 2000s, and the first GoPro in 2004 to arrive to their success in 2014. 2014 was pinpointed as the year of the wearables. Apple Watch was featured on the cover of Time magazine with the caption "Never Offline," proclaiming the official entrance of wearables and their diffusion in the contemporary society, a new always connected lifestyle. Google Glasses were on the Diane von Furstenberg's catwalk, and Fitbit announced this partnership together with Tory Burch. Then we can move to the third category, the one of augmented and virtual reality and retail. Today, communication plays a key role in the spread and perception of products, and this is why the world of fashion is constantly searching for increasingly spectacular performances that can enchant and capture the public's attention. In July 2016, Fendi celebrated its 90 years of activity by staging a fashion show on the Trevi Fountain, a spectacular event in which the clothes were almost overshadowed by the fierce media action. Similarly, Dolce & Gabbana's shows invaded the city of Naples for 4 days, launching a completely new experience. Fashion shows are no longer elitist and enclosed in a physical space, but apparently open and visible by all. There are two main ideas here: mass accessibility and spectacular elements. Technology is increasingly used for these goals, mainly in fashion shows and for trying on garments in the shops or digitally. In terms of fashion shows, technology is not only the protagonist on the catwalks, such as in the Diane von Fürstenberg's show, in which the models wore Google Glass, it is also a tool for the production of the shows themselves. For the SS 2015, Polo Ralph Lauren produced a surprising virtual show on the waters of the lake in Central Park. The models were suspended mid-air, not for the presence of see-through platforms, but thanks to the use of holographic technology that gave an evanescent and pictorial result. Even before this, for autumn-winter 2012, Daniel had staged an impressive holographic installation in Shanghai with 64 models, this time real, immersed in a virtual environment that transported London's Trafalgar Square to Shanghai and projected the changing of the seasons. The combination of cutting-edge technology, architecture, lighting and music created an extremely suggestive show in which the seasons changed inside an holographic dome. A virtual reality different to that which in 1996 Marc Dury defined as a simulation technology that uses big glasses with integrated displays and quadraphonic sound to immerse users in 3D worlds generated by computer graphics. Technology today is no longer heavy and bulky. It is light and easy to use, and it involves its user to such an extent that it has become difficult to distinguish virtual reality from the real one. Due to increased use of technology and incorporating it to the fashion industry, retail has seen the benefits of innovative technologies, with many being adopted by both startups and established companies. Besides wearables and digital manufacturing, technology has shaped fashion, first by the start of fashion blogs to leave streaming fashion shows and the introduction of the See Now, Buy Now concept to digital fitting rooms that all bringing the same supply chain closer to the customer. Augmented reality has allowed brands to introduce virtual fitting rooms where customers can try on garments virtually from their homes and in store to enhance the shopping experience. So, moving from virtual reality to augmented reality, we can have some example. The British luxury brand Emaica for Spring-Summer 2014, during the London Fashion Week, for example, the real catwalk was transformed into its digital 3D version that came to life through an ad hoc design solution, framing a scene with the tablet models walking with different dresses magically appear. The project is a winner not only because it is new and awe-inspiring, but because it is functional to staging the show in different parts of the world by simply moving the scene. The user, however, still remained a passive spectator, unlike in the application proposed by Alexander McQueen, which allowed the spectators to digitally try on the makeup used for the brand's most salient shows. This application, designed by Olition for Alexander McQueen, is called the Face, and not only allows users to try on different types of makeup, but also to go into stores and scan the product code to virtually try it on their faces thanks to the use of a smart device. Virtual try-on is the future of clothes and accessory buying. An example of smart selling is Uniqlo, which has provided one of its stores with a magic mirror, a technology that integrates physical and digital reality and allows users to add a direct in-store experience. Whilst wearing the same garment, users can see in the mirror the different available colors, take photos, share them via email or in social networks, as well as having all of the product specifications. This attention to user experience showed first emerged already a few years ago with the use of RFID technology to improve the inventory phase and customer experience through touchscreen tables with which to obtain more information on the garments, such as the available colors or sizes. If these are the innovations in the shops, in the physical and real space, we must, however, take a look also at the virtual space that is increasingly the place where new buying dynamics are forming that are close to the new generations. This means that future consumers will crowd the real shops less and less as they increasingly buy on the web. Fashion understood this and responded with the creation of virtual stores in which consumers can buy and try on the product. In 2010, Boucheron inserted augmented reality in its marketing strategy, seeing a 50% increase in its web traffic. Part of the strategy included giving consumers the possibility of trying on the most iconic jewels from the brand's collection. A luxury for the few that thus opened up to all those who wanted to experience the pleasure of wearing a Boucheron product from the comfort of their home by simply selecting it and dragging it onto the appropriate body part. And for those who cannot renounce to the experience of entering a boutique, then also thanks to augmented reality, the brand gave clients the opportunity to visit one directly from the website. Democratization and awe. These are the keywords for the future of fashion and technologies. Now we can move to the second point, that is the state of the art of the fashion field. If this is the state of the art in terms of product and processes, it is also interesting to have a general overview of who, how, and what is involved in the fashion tech field. A general observation is about the nature of fashion tech, a fragmented, disjointed reality with various and heterogeneous professionals, trends, disciplines, products, competencies, methodologies, and applications. Technology disrupts everything: the economic model, creativity, manufacturing, textiles. But the real challenge lies in the connection between innovations brought about by new technologies and traditional methods. High-tech products must also be fashion products, embodying a sensory appeal and emotion, and therefore a desirability. You have to use technology but also transcend it, says Morand, the executive president of the Fédération de la Haute Couture et de la Mode. But going through who, is involved in the field of fashion tech. As previously mentioned, the world of fashion tech is characterized primarily by an extremely heterogeneous nature. This can also be applied to the disciplines that characterize it, and there are three areas that cover the fashion tech field: the one of design, natural science and engineering, and economics and management. The design area includes fashion design and industrial design that deal with the specific product, garments or accessory. Communication design that has the task, instead of transmitting the communication of the product. The user experience design that studies the interaction with the final consumer, and finally the generative design that is placed halfway between the creative and technical field. Then we have the technical field, named natural science engineering, instead indicates all the purely technical skills that cover the development of embedded technologies, smart textiles, and machinery or real-life technologies for digital manufacturing. Among these skills, in electronic, textile, biometric, and software engineering, but also in chemistry and biology, stand out. The last one, the economics and management, refers to areas such as business management, supply chain management, and market intelligence that have an informative and management role along the entire production chain. All these sectors require a new hybrid figure that is able to control every phase of the methodology, and that is the answer to how can fashion tech be produced? This professional must be able to connect the dots between the different professional figures by making sure that shared tools for knowledge are defined. But how it is possible to create a link between so different scenarios? Integration is the keyword, intended not only as integration of technology and products, but also as integration of processes, languages, and professional figures. And this is nothing else but the learning of the masters of the design, that is, that designing doesn't mean inventing new shapes, but creating new behaviors. In a so complex area as the one of fashion tech, it is also useful to clearly understand what we are talking about. So, to answer to the question what, we have to say that there are three main areas involved in fashion tech, and they were remodeled in a very smart way in the benchmarking report of the Edo for Fashion Tech Erasmus Plus project. In that way, wearables are on-body products such as clothing, footwear, accessories, and jewelry designed to create a communication interaction enabled by technologies such as digital and virtual to amplify and extend natural ability and performance of the human body, or add new functions to the user connecting him with his body, with other person or objects, and with the environment. Then we have smart textiles that are knitted, woven, and non-woven fabric systems designed to sense and respond to external stimuli, such as mechanical, thermal, chemical, biological, magnetic, or electrical, enabled by advanced physical and digital technologies. At least we have digital manufacturing, that is an integrated approach to manufacturing that is centered around a computational system using tools such as 3D technologies, robotics, AI and AR, and the integration between digital technologies for manufacturing processes and embedded digital technologies in products, service, Internet of Things in general, to enable open and distributed manufacturing that can reshape design, production, distribution, and retail processes. The extent of applications ranges from large-scale industrial system, industry 4.0 and do-it-yourself, mini and micro factory, up to digital service platforms, and bottom-up innovation processes, on-demand manufacturing, collaborative and on-site manufacturing, repairing and remanufacturing systems. This is the answer to who, how, and what is involved in the fashion tech field, so the main actors in this completely new innovative scenario. It is what fashion tech is today, but combining desk research and observation of changing in the contemporary era, emerging topics has been obtained. In particular, five macro areas emerged that may represent a direction of future development for the fashion tech sector. We will see the first one, protection and body enhancement through artificial second skin, then culture-driven wearable, art, technology and innovation, the third one, hyperbody connecting senses and materials, then fashion tech takes care, and finally real and virtual mixed environments. Starting from the idea that a trend is a direction of movement or change in an observed value, information is the common denominator among all the emerging future directions that are described later. These are not market trends, but indicators and results of an observation, as I said, and an analysis of emerging issues in the latest researches that represent the macro areas of tomorrow's products and processes within fashion tech. Some still in an early stage, other decidedly advanced. The first one is protection and body enhancement through artificial second skin, and protection is considered as taking care of your own body, enhancing and monitoring physiological, neurological and body kinematic parameters that are critical for healthcare. Protection means also safety and comfort. While products related to health and well-being have previously been focused on providing information on the user's vital signs for a quantified self to improve lifestyle and control it, the wearables and the smart textiles with embedded sensors are able to monitor physiological, neurological, and body kinematic parameters that are critical for healthcare. Body signs such as heart rate, respiration, and motion patterns can provide data to detect behavioral changes and health risks and diagnose at early stages. The biggest part of these products is connected more with an area of smart textiles and wearables than with the one of digital manufacturing. In fact, fashion and product designers and textile and electronics and material engineers are the main professional figures involved in this macro area. It is a major and marketable trend, mainly design-driven, that come from the robotics, automotive, military, and defense and machine fields. The second one is culture-driven wearable, art, technology and interaction, exploring how human and technology relate and communicate, enabled by data and co-creation, along with how technology affects people's lives and livelihood and shapes notions such as trust, ethics and power. Fashion tech plays a role in being a human, its relationship, activities and related consequences. It can communicate and articulate what we stand for, public expression demonstrating our beliefs, values, politics and cultural context. Thus, a culture-driven wearable approach opens up new possibilities that allow and support social conversations about democracy, ethics, behavior, trust, and resilience. Design has the potential to change attitudes and has the power to change culture in a single gesture, and it is the core of the last future direction. Designers and artists have the power to generate thoughts and knowledge around human behaviors, interaction with the body, other people and the environment. Substantially, the idea is to have a strong impact on human behaviors, relationship, gesture and, more in general, on contemporary culture. In society, we must develop an awareness of how technology is constantly changing and evolving. Therefore, new questions arise and are explored through creative provocations, ideas, and explorations, sometimes enabled data-driven design. Design invites responses to rethink and reimagine our relationship with technology and reshaping cultural shift in a hyper-connected world. By involving areas of wearables and digital manufacturing, expertise of fashion designers, artists, architects, and electronic engineers are necessary and are often enabled by additive manufacturing. The third direction is the one of hyperbody, connecting senses and materials. And technology integrates the senses of the body, eyesight, hearing, touch, to give additional languages and connection to the users. In the relation between technology and design, the body plays an important role. While on one side the technologies are becoming contactless, wireless, on the other side products with embedded technologies are becoming more and more connected with body and skin. In some cases they become really part of them. Starting from medicine, engineering, military and defense fields, artists, fashion and textile designers, together with electronic engineers, can explore how to create new languages for the body, specifically designing wearables and smart textiles. The fourth direction is the one of fashion takes care, and it's about sustainability that goes across design, production and retail, covering the entire supply chain, and it is intended as efficiency, recyclability, transparency, mission orientation and ethical upgrades. Sustainability goes across design, production and retail, covering, as we said, the entire supply chain, and it is intended as efficiency, recyclability, transparency, mission orientation and ethical upgrades. Involving mainly smart textiles and digital manufacturing, the level of maturity of this trend is very high, and also it is marketability. Usually the presence of technology is beyond the scenes, and it is managed by material and textile engineers, biologist, computer scientist, and at least fashion and product designers. Last but not least, real and virtual mixed environments, that is the exploration of new environments, the space and the idea of creating specific garments or accessories for it. New unreal places created with mixed reality as results of the addition of virtual and augmented reality. New dimensions for self-assembly and programmable materials. Fashion architectures, real or digital, as a result of technical and material innovation and inventions, guarantee an experience to the consumer. Fashion architecture also means exploring or building environments, the space and the idea of creating specific garments or accessories for it, analogical or digital places created and customized with mixed reality as result of the addition of virtual and augmented reality. But also new dimensions for self-assembly and programmable materials, artificial intelligence for all the supply chain. These are the five macro trends for fashion tech. Our journey in the fashion tech field is at the end, and I hope you could understand the variability of the fashion tech field, its contemporary state of the art, and its hidden opportunities. In particular, how a design-driven perspective, human-centered and processes-driven, has a central role in the evolution of fashion tech, both in the development of specific approaches and in the creation of new and shared knowledge among involved actors and sectors.